It's research and development where I've got a handful of ideas that are not the mainstream. I follow most of what the mainstream is doing because it's fabulous. It's useful. Right now I'm following up on some research papers from last year that I think have more utility for the way I want to apply them than what their original authors were looking at. There's valuable things that happened earlier that people aren't necessarily aware of. There's some work from like the 70s, 80s, and 90s that I actually think might be interesting because a lot of things happened back then that didn't pan out just because they didn't have enough scale. They were trying to do this on 1 megahertz computers, not clusters of GPUs. And there is this kind of groupthink I mentioned that is really clear if you look at it about all these brilliant researchers. They all have similar backgrounds and they're all kind of swimming in the same direction. So there's a few of these old things back there that I think may be useful. So right now I'm building experiments, I'm testing things, I'm trying to marry together some of these fields that are distinct that have what I feel are pieces of the AGI algorithm. But most of what I do is I run simulations through watching lots of television and playing various video games. And I think that combination of here's how you perceive and internalize a model of the world and here's how you act in it with agency in some of these situations. I still don't know how they come together, but I think there are keys there. I think I have my arms around the scope of the problems that need to be solved and how to push things together. I still think there's a half dozen insights that need to happen, but I've got a couple of things that are plausible insights that might turn out to be relevant. And one of the things that I trained myself to do a few decades ago is pulling ideas out and pursuing them in a way where I'm excited about them, knowing that most of them don't pan out in the end. Much earlier in my career, when I'd have a really bright idea that didn't work out, I was crushed afterwards. But eventually, I got to the point where I'm really good at just shoveling ideas through my processing and shooting them down, almost making it a game to say, how quickly can I bust my own idea rather than protecting it as a pet idea? So I've got a few of these candidates right now that I'm in the process of exploring and attacking, but it's going to be these abstract ideas and techniques and ways to apply things that are similar to the way deep learning is done right now. So I'm pushing off scaling it out because there are a bunch of companies now saying, we need to go raise $100 million, $200 million because we need to have a warehouse full of GPUs. And that's one path to value, and there's a little bit of a push toward that. But I'm very much pushing towards saying, no, I want to figure out these six important things before I go waste $100 million of someone's money. I'm actually not spending much money right now. I raised $20 million, but I'm thinking that this is a decade-long task where I don't want to burn through $20 million in the next 2 years, then raise another series to get another couple hundred million dollars because I don't actually think that's the smart way to go about things. My hope is that I can spend several years working through some of these things, building small things that I think point in the right directions, and then throw some scale at it and push an entire lifetime of information and experience through this and see if it comes out with something that shows that spark. Because again, I don't expect how to pop out of this. What I keep saying is that as soon as you're at the point where you have the equivalent of a toddler, something that is a being, it's conscious, it's not Einstein, it can't even do multiplication. If you've got a creature that can learn, you can interact with and teach it things on some level. And at that point, you can deploy an army of engineers, developmental psychologists, and scientists to study things. Because we don't have that yet. We don't have the ability to simulate something that's a being like that. There are tricks and techniques and strategies that the brain is doing that none of our existing models do. But getting to that point doesn't look out of reach to me.